My doctor told me that this is something that could possibly change your whole life.
12 cancer patients, one experimental treatment, an astonishing result.
That day, I didn't see the tumor. Maybe I thought it's hiding somewhere inside. The doctor told me, like, there is no more tumor. It's a miracle.
In a tiny clinical trial in New York, the small group of patients with advanced rectal cancer and a specific mutation received the drug Dostarlimab, administered every 3 weeks for 6 months.
It completely eliminated the cancer. The tumors just vanished.
Within a year of the trial, every single patient saw their cancer disappear.
It's absolutely incredible. We didn't expect it. It's really what, you know, cancer doctors' dreams are made of.
You expect that it might work in a percentage of patients. You'd be pretty happy if it worked in half of them, but to see it work in all of them, albeit it's a very small number, that is something very unusual.
Dostarlimab is an antibody drug that is already used to treat endometrial cancer, but it's the first time it's been trialled against rectal cancer tumours. None of the patients experienced significant side effects.
It went from this really terrifying experience to something where I could feel like, okay, maybe I can get through this.
Rectal cancer patients often face grueling treatment, chemo, radiation, and life-altering surgery, often requiring colostomy bags.
You go from feeling, oh, am I gonna die? Am I gonna lose my colon? And then to find that, like, oh, you're gonna be fine. It's just like, wow, it's an amazing feeling.
But while the results from this trial are truly remarkable, they're yet to be replicated.
There's a lot of study still need to be done, but the signal that we're looking for is there, and we get excited about positive signals.
Last year, more than 15,000 Australians were diagnosed with colorectal cancer.
I'm a miracle, like right here, standing without any surgery, don't have cancer. The first thing I did, I called my mom. Yeah, we both cried. It was life-changing.
Associate Professor Graham Newstead was a colorectal surgeon for more than 40 years and now he's the medical director at Bowel Cancer Australia. Graham, this all sounds amazing. You've been in the game a while. What do you make of this?
Well, we've seen a lot of change over the time. I'd make a prediction for the future, and that is I don't think it'll be too many years, 5, 10, 20, 30, before we are injecting stuff into people to get rid of their cancers. Rather than operating on them. So maybe I've retired at a good time. But this is innovative chemotherapy. Now, it's very early days, and let's all not get too excited, not throw away the scalpels yet. But we have a very, very small study, but it showed a complete absence of expected recurrent cancer in a particular group of patients with rectal cancer. And that is an amazing thing, to have 0% of expected recurrent cancer. So it's a really important start.
Well, the patients also experience no extreme side effects. How much of a big deal is that?
Yeah, that's important, because normally one would expect in most of the chemotherapeutic agents a certain amount of nausea or a change in their blood count and lots of other side effects. There are countless. But to have no level 3 side effects in all those patients is an amazing thing. So it's pretty stimulating. Now, we as lay people, including myself, because these are the experts doing the special oncological studies, should all now sit back and wait. But in due course, they will have enough figures and enough patients who have been through the process, comparing with patients who are of a similar ilk but haven't been through the process, to be able to say that scientifically this is a proven product, in which case the company can then make a few dollars and try and save the world.
Well, we've seen, obviously, science do some stunning work in the last couple of years, Graham, and roll out the vaccines, you know, quicker than we possibly could have hoped for. Has that inspired the scientific community to now we have these really promising results to get more heads and eyes on it and perhaps get it to us quicker than perhaps previously?
Yeah, when penicillin was invented as the first antibiotic, it was extraordinary and an amazing amount of work. Now, we don't forget, we've got all these many, many years behind us. So now we're at a stage where all the basic information, the how to do it, the way not to do it is there. So when the vaccine for COVID was invented, it wasn't as if they were starting from scratch. I mean, you can get your heart stents replaced, you can get your hips joints replaced, you can get your vessels replaced and today and have good chemo for a lot of these. And it won't be long before maybe even our failing neurons in our brains will be prevented from failing and we'll live to 120. Lord knows where we'll actually physically live then, but at least we've got the basics behind us now and the advances are amazing. I used to use a knife and fork and a piece of string to remove a bowel cancer. Now, more recently we moved to the laparoscopic work. Now we can sit in a corner like a Pac-Man game and actually do robotic work where we're not even touching our patient to remove the bowel cancer. And there are expenses in that, but there are benefits as well. So this is could be a significant advance we'll see in the next year or two. But if it comes to fruition, then the sky's the limit.
We have had a few reasons to marvel at science in recent years, haven't we? And Prof, I've got to say, listening to you tonight, all I can say is wow. It's just incredible.
I hope it is a wow. And it's certainly worth watching while much cleverer people than me play with their test tubes in the lab and hopefully bring this to some fruition, yeah.
They may be clever, but their shirts aren't as cool, Graham.
Yes.
No doubt.
That's true.
Thank you.
That is a scientific fact, Graham. Thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure, and thank you for listening.